Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Parkway United Church of Christ, where through God's Spirit we seek to build community, act for justice, and listen deeply. If you were in doubt, we're not the only ones who celebrate Christmas. That's from the Hubble telescope this week, Cassiopeia A. Sparkling away. Welcome to our celebration of community renewal. At this time, I'm going to invite those who are on the front pew to pass along the sign-in booklets. We'd be thrilled to have your updated contact information so we can continue to be in community with you beyond this service of worship. Hopefully on the way in, you received a candle. If you did not, we'll make sure you get one. At the close of our service, we will be passing the light. And just a safety reminder, the one who has the unlighted candle dips to light from the candle that is already lighted. Also, on the way in, hopefully you've got a pen, a Parkway pen. It is your gift to you. And the prophet Habakkuk says, write the vision, make it plain. And that's what we're commissioning you to do today. Write your vision of love in the world. Your own life vision, this community's vision. Write the vision, make it plain. Be bold. Use a lot of verbs. Spice it up with some zesty adverbs. Use squiggles and arcs and exclamation points. Our lives depend on it. After church, we're hoping that in the front area, some call it the narthex, you can grab something to snack on and something to drink and be in community with one another. So I invite you now. I invite you now to just take a moment as we have practice of centering ourselves in our bodies for worship. Those who are able, I invite you to hold open your hands in front of you. Take a look at those hands. What have those hands already done today? How have they nurtured, offered love, family, community? How have they offered you gifts of your own well-being? However fresh or wrinkly, however smooth or calloused, however nimble or arthritic, these are the hands of incarnation, of the enfleshed sacred among us. Go ahead, wave them. Let them dance a little bit. Maybe even respectfully reach out to a neighbor in the pew. Celebrate all of your body. Wiggle into your Christmas body now. We, together with so many siblings and nibblings across the globe, are Emmanuel. Consider that. We are Emmanuel. we have our first musical selection.
we hope, awaiting God's justice. We seek peace, awaiting God's shalom. We stir up joy, awaiting God with us. We seek love, awed by God's love for us. We invite you to rise in body and our spirit as you are able for our opening hymn, O Come All You Faithful.
Concerns. At this time, I'm going to invite those in our Zoom worshiping community to share what you have to celebrate or a prayer request that you may have. So glad to have all of you with us in worship today. A few I'm aware of. Dolores Kay is recovering from a procedure earlier last week. Ann M. is recovering from RSV in Thomasville. Tom E. is trying to get well from pneumonia. Mary M. has had some health concerns. We continue to pray for Bill and Deborah. Greg W. is continuing in the hospital, recovering from the flu. Andrea M's mom is recovering from heart condition. Jim W, we continue to keep Jim in prayer. We celebrate birthdays this week of Dolores K and Pat V. Pray for all of those who are currently suffering with COVID or RSV or the flu, those who are lonely, those who are struggling with mental health situations, family strife, economic and employment challenges. I'm going to invite those of you in the sanctuary to share what is on your heart today. Yes, Beth.
Ongoing prayers for our nation's political health and the upcoming election.
For our nation's political health and the upcoming election. Yes, Craig.
Merry Christmas, Church.
Merry Christmas, Church. Shashi.
I just want to send my son his home and he has followed
Shashi's son, who's found a wonderful mate. Shashi, as she recovers from her back injury. Jim?
We'd like to pray for Kaneen, a friend of ours who's making a transition right now.
For Kaneen making a transition at this point. Robert?
Yes, pray for all we have many people that are ailing in our congregation, but there's a lot of people in these hospitals. Let's pray for these workers, nurses, doctors, and specialists that are caring for them 24 hours a day, even though it's Christmas Eve. They'll be there tonight and all day tomorrow. Take care of these people.
For all our healthcare workers and health care providers over here. Yes, Lee?
Make a special prayer for people who are struggling because of the loss of a loved one.
Those who are grieving loss of a loved one, especially this time of year. Ada? Terry Nelson's birthday. Happy birthday, Terry. I saw some hands over. Yes, Nan? Who are grieving loss of loved ones who have died in accidents. Yes, John.
Prayers for the people of Israel and Palestine.
For all those in Israel, Palestine.
Yes. My name is Susan. My father, John, is in a rehab for a broken hip. Not doing real well, so we pray for him, please.
We pray for John and Susan, as John is recovering from a broken hip. Yes, Sterling.
It's a joy to see everyone this morning. Members that have had to go away for school or have just come back to visit family and friends and guests. So we're just excited that you're here to worship with us this morning. Very excited.
Yes. Just a delight to have folks we haven't seen in a while. Join us for this time of celebration. I'm going to call out the Evans family. It's good to have them with us today. Says a delight to have young people back in our midst. Yes, Jim.
Celebrating Phillips' retirement.
Phillips' retirement. Yes. From the Zoom chat, Dolores, today is my 91st birthday. All is well. Diane prays for her sister recovering from knee surgery. Peggy asks for prayers for Susan T. and for Terry and Terry. Anybody else from Zoom today? I'm going to invite us just to move into a few moments of stillness as we realize so many of our celebrations and prayers have not been mentioned aloud, and so this is an opportunity to sit in sacred presence for a few moments with all that is on our hearts. And then I will invite us to join together in the prayer Jesus taught in the language and tradition of your choosing. Our Father, Mother, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sin as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. It's time to share a sign of peace with one another. As a resilience-informed community, we're respectful of various health concerns and body autonomy. Share a sign of peace.
Hello.
Peace, everybody.
Peace with everyone.
Hey, Sandy.
Hey, Diane. Merry Christmas to everyone.
Hello, everybody.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Hey, Diane.
Hey.
Hi, y'all.
Hello.
Merry Christmas to all of you. Good to see you. Happy New Year.
You all have a great day.
Yes, you too.
Everybody.
Merry Christmas to everybody.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you for all of you.
I hope you all get to see family today.
I'll see part of mine today and all of it tomorrow.
Oh, that sounds wonderful.
Yes,
wonderful.
That does, Peggy. So glad.
I take that back. The sun has already left.
Mary and Jim, hope you all are doing well.
We will. Mm-hmm.
And my friend Diane.
Amen.
And happy birthday to Dolores.
Yes, happy birthday, Dolores.
Big one. Diane Stallings, how are you?
Feed you all day long.
You're muted, Diane.
She knows it.
All of our family was here yesterday, and we're trying to recover this morning.
I understand recovery.
It's very quiet here today.
Well, it probably is nice.
I'm gearing up for the noise tomorrow.
Woo! Oh, sorry.
Can we shut the floor down?
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child.
House and family of David. You know, some people say house and lineage of David. Sounds regal, doesn't it? A lineage of supplanters, scoundrels, and strivers is all. Just trying to figure out how to make it in this world. A lineage that includes women like Tamar and Rahab and Bathsheba, used and abused and tossed and tumbled in this story of a people trying to hold on to a promise, hold on to a relationship with the God of their ancestors. And now the lineage of David means very little to these Romans, forcing us into dangerous marches to places that only our ancestors knew of, forcing us into long queues to register like counted sheep, counted cattle, counted to be taxed into landlessness is really what it's all about. Yet I have hope. Why wouldn't you when you have a little one on the way? Their mother seems to be a little distracted, often with a distant gaze, I guess. I only hope that she sees, well, I hope that her gaze and distance means that she sees something bright in the future with this child that the rest of us do not yet see. Count yourselves as part of the lineage of David. I'm sure your people have a similar mixed lot. Truth be told, come on. Be counted for your goodness and your mercy. Your own little ways of healing the lineage for the future of all of us. Please join me in the unison prayer. You come, always alive on arrival, stirring within us and between us a longing for new life, new minds, new ways, good news.
scripture this morning, Luke 2nd, verses 6 and 7. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them at the inn.
Wonderful to see everybody. I come from telling a story online from the World Storytelling Festival out of Marrakesh, Morocco. And many people there with connections, particularly to Palestine and folks who are having a very hard time there. This song was written by John McCutcheon. I'm John Sundell. He's not here. But he is an old friend of mine who I used to sing with. Picture yourself in the trenches of World War I. Oh, my name is Francis Tolliver. Come from Liverpool. 2 years ago, the war was waiting for me after school. To Belgium and to Flanders, to Germany to here. I fought for king and country I loved dear. It was Christmas in the trenches, and the frost so bitter hung. The frozen fields of France were still, no Christmas songs were sung. Our families back in England, they were toasting us that day. Their brave and glorious lads so far away. I was lying with me messmates on the cold and rocky ground. And across the line of battle came a most peculiar sound. Says I, now listen up, me boys, each soldier strained to hear. This one young German voice sang out so clear. You're singing bloody well, you know, my partner says to me. Soon one by one each German voice joined in harmony. The cannons rested silent and the gas clouds rolled no more. This Christmas brought us respite from the war. As soon as they were finished, and a reverent pause was spent, God rest ye merry gentlemen, struck off some lads from Kent. The next they sang was Stille Nacht, is silent night, says I, and in two tongues one song filled up that sky. There's someone coming towards us now, the front line sentry cried. All sights were fixed on one lone figure trudging from their side. His truce flag like a Christmas star shone on that plain so bright as we bravely strode unarmed into the night. Soon one by one on either side walked into no man's land. With neither guns nor bayonets, we met there hand to hand. We shared some secret brandy, and we wished each other well. And And in a flare-lit soccer game, we gave them hell. We traded chocolates, cigarettes, and photographs from home. These sons and fathers far away from families of their own. Young Flanders had a squeeze box, and they had a violin. This curious and unlikely band of men. Daylight stole upon us. France was France once more. With sad farewells, we each began to settle back to war. But the question haunted every heart that lived that wondrous night. Whose family have I fixed within my sights? It's Christmas in the trenches, and the frost so bitter hung. Frozen fields of France were warm, the songs of peace were sung. For the walls they built between us to exact the work of war had been crumbled, were gone forevermore. My name is Francis Tolliver, in Liverpool I dwell. Each Christmas comes since World War I, I've learned my lesson well. That the ones who call the shots won't be among the dead and lame. And at each end of the rifle, we're the same.
Scriptures from Luke 2, 8 through 14. Now in that same region there were shepherds living in the fields. Thank you. Keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone round them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. Do not be afraid, for you, born today in the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign unto you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. That's the standard line for angels. Because everyone we visit is terrified, or at least perplexed. Happened to Zechariah, John's dad. It happened to Mary. Now it happens to the shepherds. Second thought, maybe you should be afraid. Because when we show up, things will never be the same. There's no going back. You see something that you can't not see anymore. It's for goodness and mercy and all that other stuff too. But we aren't just the celestial folk who show up for the birth of a savior. Angels show up more than you think. We show up more than you think. You show up more than you think. Mostly, we don't have blinding, backlighting, or the wings of a swan. We've got grease under our nails, or carry the whiff of cleaning supplies, Fabuloso, Pine Sol. We've got 5 o'clock shadows, and those also achy knees. We appear to show you there is something else still possible when you seem to have worn out all the possibilities. When we come, feel free to be a little afraid. Just don't be intimidated. We're only showing up for your own good. Together, Spirit, give us senses to see and hear and smell your coming in all kinds of places and times, sometimes when we least expect it. Amen.
I'm going to read from Luke 2, verses 15 through 20. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which Adonai has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them.
Got a lot of moving parts up and on off here today, but anyway. But Tim and I are both extremely happy to sing this song for you today.
Check, check, check.
Okay.
What she said.
Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem, shining afar through shadows dim, giving
shine upon us until the glory.
Good morning. My name's David. Some of you know I'm just a shepherd. But it's interesting, isn't it, that we shepherds, we're the first preachers, proclaimers of the good news of the Christ. Yep, those of us on the underbelly of society, with sheep dung stuck to our feet. Who else could have been chosen to announce praise for a kid born in a barn? Funny how mystery has this way of taking those of us who are on the margin and putting them in the center of the story for a while. Consider the times that maybe you feel you've been on the margin. How is holiness putting you in the center of love and light? Join me in the unison prayer. Anoint us, blessed Jesus, for your work of proclaiming good news. Only when necessary, have us use words.
I am grateful to be among you on this Christmas Eve morning. Thank you for being here. You all know, who know me, always know I get choked up. Thank you for showing up time and again to do the work of the church. For the musical gifts that are so generously shared in this community, and that always seem like magic to me, who doesn't really possess those. And for the love and support that you give one another, those are the gifts that make this such a special community. Your financial gifts do other things. They give us this building with its stunning tree of life in the back. This morning, it gives us heat and light. It gives us this very talented director of music and our extraordinary ministers, Craig and Michelle. Where'd she go? She was right there. I planned all along to point to you. Please give as you are able. There is an offering plate in the back. You can mail a check to the church office. You can go online and give your gift the way many of us do these days. Thank you.
Thank you.
Luke 2:19. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart.
Has me pondering and treasuring in my heart at every turn, like I'm some docile china doll. When Gabriel gives me a fright, I ponder. When the shepherds come with their boisterous praise, I ponder and treasure. When later we finally find Jesus arguing in the temple, I treasure in my heart. Really, it's what every and any mother, any parent does, isn't it? Hoping for satisfaction and joy tinged with some worry, but anything but docile, fierce, advocating, tenacious. After the circumcision, the prophet Anna said something to me that nobody talks about. She looked me plainly in the eye and said, "This kiddo of yours is going to be a sign. Many won't like it, but through him, the inner thoughts of many will be revealed." What people ponder and treasure, will become bodies in motion, will become a way of being, will become prayer in action. Somehow, I already knew that even before he was born. Join with me in the unison prayer. When we are brokenhearted or lost or confused, may you help to open our hearts to new information, new relationship, new experience, new ways of prayer.
Reading from the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verses 1 through 4. In the beginning was the conversation, and the conversation was with God, and the conversation was God. This was the God in the beginning. All things came into being through him. And apart from this, nothing came into being that has come into being. And the conversation became flesh and dwelt among us. Physicist Fritjof Capra tried to describe the relationship of the physical world. A seismic particle is not a thing, but an interconnection between things. And these things, in turn, are interconnections between other things. Victoria Lopez says it well in The Church in the Wild. Entering into true conversation with each other and with the earth, we participate in the story of Christ. Our collective unfolding, the conversation, is inside flesh there.
We rejoice in God's steadfast presence in our lives and in God's unique presence in the life of Jesus of Nazareth. Born of Mary, growing through childhood into adulthood, providing ministry, and through all his life manifesting wildness and love and justice of God. We will indeed light this light and pass it to one another as a sign. We will continue to grow intimate with this power and hope and transform through conversation. Thank you.
sing Silent Night together.
And know that you continue to carry the light into the world. I invite you to once again notice your hands. Where will these hands be? What will they do to continue
the conversation, the enfleshing of sacred presence in our midst, in the world. Go and adjust peace. Don't forget there are snacks and beverages. But also, if you've not had a chance to sign up for one of our vision implementation teams, there are newsprint all along the hallway, and we invite you to sign up. Just take your pen and put your name right on one of the five. Merry Christmas. Thanks for being with us.